Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are all doing well. So in today's video, I am going to review the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte Foundation. I am trying out this foundation for 3 to 4 weeks now, and I am super excited to share my thoughts with you guys, because today in this video, I am not only going to share my thoughts, but I am also going to test it out, not for 24 hours. I don't recommend that. You should not sleep with your makeup on, but I'm going to try it out and I'm going to test it out, and I'm going to show you guys the final result, and I'm also going to share my thoughts with you guys. So yeah, keep on watching and make sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and let's get started. Okay, so we are ready to test out our foundation. Do you guys like my sweater? Like, obviously out of topic question, but I am loving this. I am loving this cozy weather right now. I just can't wait for winters. Like, can't wait for that. Anyways, this is the foundation and this is what it looks like. This is the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte Foundation, and you have 9 total shades available in India. I have this shade Natural Beige. I purchased it from Nykaa and this is not my shade. When you're purchasing online, you don't know what shade you're exactly buying. We are gonna manage that. So this is in the shade 105 Natural Beige. So this costs for 799 rupees for 30 ml product, and this is what the packaging looks like. This L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte Foundation claims that this is a give your skin a semi matte finish, and this is a long wear, like a super long wear foundation which will last up to 24 hours. This will give you a smooth and flawless coverage. We will see that. Okay, so this is what the packaging looks like. I am actually not gonna complain anything about the packaging. I really, really love the packaging. I personally prefer pump packaging, but this plastic tube packaging is also really nice. There is nothing to complain about the packaging. It's really nice. Everything is mentioned right over here, and every ingredient is mentioned right over here. Everything is claimed right over here that this will give you a demi matte finish, air light, oil free foundation. So yeah, the shade name is also written right over here. So I am not gonna complain anything about the packaging. I really, really love the packaging. I'm gonna use the foundation and I am just gonna talk about this foundation, what I think. So no, I don't use primer because it's not my thing. I don't really like using primer. I really like using a moisturizer, and this is my go-to moisturizer. I'm not using anything new because I don't want, as I'm using this foundation, as I'm testing out this foundation, I don't want anything new underneath my makeup moisturizer. And I am going to, oh, by the way, this is the Pond's for soft and glowing skin lightweight moisturizer, and I really like this moisturizer. Okay, so I zoomed you guys in a little bit so that you guys can see this is what my skin looks like. You can see some acne marks right over here, some acne marks right over here, some pigmentation going on my skin, and I have a pretty oily plus combination skin. I have a pretty oily T-zone and a combination normal to dry kind of cheeks and all this area. So first I'm gonna use a brush on this side of my face, and I'm gonna use a blender on this side of my face. And actually you need a little bit, like one drop. So I'm just gonna take a little bit, just kind of one drop over here, because this foundation, like, little goes a long way with this foundation. So you just need a little bit with this foundation. So I am just going to use this and I'm going to show you guys how this looks. By the way, I am using a duo fiber brush, and I am going to use this. As you can see, this is not my shade. This is too light for my skin, but okay, we can manage. As you can see, I am blending this foundation all over my skin. You have to work really, really fast with this foundation, because this foundation dries out very, very quickly. So you have to blend it out really, really quickly. So I am just using it all over my face. This is what my skin looks like with one layer of foundation. You can see my acne marks already. This contains a pretty much medium to light coverage, as it already claims. So I am just gonna take a little bit more just for my forehead. Oh, this color is not my shade. This is not my shade. Thank you. you can see, you have to blend it out really, really fast. This dries out so quickly. You have to blend this out. I'm just gonna bring it down towards my neck a little bit because it's too light for my skin. Okay, so as you can see, this is my skin without foundation and this is my skin with foundation. As you guys can see, it smoothed out my skin pretty well. I just cannot feel that there is a heavy layer of foundation on my skin. This foundation is really, really lightweight, and obviously this is only one layer on my skin, but this is really, really lightweight. It's actually giving me a semi-matte finish because this is not actually matte. As you guys can see, a little bit glow going on right over here, so this is actually giving me a semi matte finish, which is really nice for a dry skin person. This foundation is not for you. I think if you're a dry skin person, you should not use this foundation, because you are a dry skin person and a matte foundation, like, obviously you can use it, but you have to use a dewy primer underneath. You should use a heavy moisturizer underneath your skin, or else the foundation will look little bit patchy underneath your skin. So I think I'm just gonna go with one layer, because usually don't like using too much foundation. A little bit. Just hating this shade. This is not my shade. I'm looking like a white ghost. Just gonna bring it down a little bit. Okay, so this is what my skin is looking a blender. As usual, I am loving the blender side more. Now, I don't know why, but my nose is kind of looking a little bit patchy. And this is what my skin is looking with the blender. And this is what my skin was looking with a brush. I will definitely recommend you to use this with a blender actually. It blended into my skin really, really well. I'm just going to use some concealer on my under eyes, and I'm just going to set my under eyes with some powder. I'm not going to use any concealer or anything on the rest of my face. I just really, really want to try out this foundation. I am just going to use a little bit of bronzer because obviously want to see how it looks, whether it looks a little bit patchy or not. It really blends out with this foundation. So yeah, I am just going to finish up with my makeup. So this is what my makeup is looking right now. I am loving it. Maine powder se apna pura face set bhi nahi kiya hai. Still my makeup is looking like it's quite in place. I used this concealer from Wet n Wild. I used my Nykaa Skin Genius powder to set my concealer. I used my Absolute New York bronzer and this lip shade from this brand right over here. I am gonna mention everything down in the description box below for you guys. And this is what my makeup is looking right now. When I was applying my bronzer, mujhe koi bhi problem nahi ho raha tha. I was not feeling like it's moving the foundation or anything like that. I am pretty much very impressed with this foundation, and this is like one layer and this is what it looks like. It is giving me pretty good coverage. I don't use high coverage foundation, but this kind of coverage is pretty well for me. So I think it's best for oily skin people, and for dry skin people, I think you should try it out with different kind of primers and moisturizers, heavy based moisturizer, then only you can see a difference. So yeah, I'm just gonna go now and I'm gonna finish up some work, and I will be right back after a few hours. Okay, so I just want to show you guys how it looks on natural lighting. So this is what my skin is looking. Oh my god, this is what my skin is looking right now. As you guys can see, my nose is looking very, very patchy. I don't know why, but my nose is actually looking very, very patchy. Like right over here, only my nose. But rather than that, my face is looking quite good. My makeup is looking quite good. And this is what my skin is looking like after 3 hours. So I think this foundation is working really, really well. I can't see anything bad except my nose. Foundation is working pretty well. I was using a ring light, so I just wanted to show you guys on natural daylight how it really looks. I am going to test it out for a few more hours and then I will be right back. I was just applying my lipstick because there was no lipstick at all after, I think it's been like 7 hours, I think. Oh my god, I just want to take off my makeup. I'm so tired right now. So yeah guys, this is what my skin is looking right now, and I'm quite happy about this foundation. I am loving the result, loving the result. As you guys saw, this foundation was really, really light for my skin, but right now it's looking like it was perfect for my skin. So I will say this foundation oxidized a little bit. This foundation do oxidize because this foundation shade was not my shade, exactly looking like my shade. So this foundation definitely oxidized. So the first point, it oxidized a little bit. The second point is it dries out really quickly. So if you are a dry skin person, I will not recommend that. And the next thing, it dries out really, really quickly. So you have to work really, really fast. So this is the thing that I don't like about this foundation. But the thing that I like about this foundation is it's beautiful. After so many hours, like, this foundation is looking pretty good. As I already told you guys, except my nose, like except this part, my foundation is looking pretty nice. Scented foundations are not my thing. So this is fragrance free. This blends out really well. It will take some time. You have to work out really, really fast. It will blend out really well. And this will stay on your face for really, really long. It's a long lasting foundation. If you're looking for a long lasting foundation, this is the foundation for you. This will work really well for oily skin people. And what else? I think this is what I want to say about this foundation. Foundation review is kind of a thing which depends. Like, if I'm liking this foundation, you, this is kind of a personal thing. You may not like this foundation. You should try this foundation out and do let me know your thoughts. What you think about this foundation? I would love to know that. So yeah guys, that's it for today's video. I hope you guys find this video helpful. All the links will be down in the description box below and the products will be mentioned down in the description box below. Make sure to check that out. I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you guys on my next video. Bye.